Is it just me, or are single player games just boring? We're going to be talking about all that and more, but first, coffee. All right, today's coffee is Peru El Parugo Mountain. Have a nice look at those tasty beans. So the reason that I'm talking about this topic today is that actually when the pandemic started happening earlier this year, I did a stream. It's kind of just random weekend stream where I decided to play a non-fighting game. I know, crazy, right? Playing a game that's non-fighting games, crazy. And I was playing a game that a lot of people had suggested to me for a long time called Nier Automata, right? And I'm not gonna try and say that Nier is boring. Let's grind! When I was playing this game, Nier, I've played about 2 or 3 hours of it on stream. And there are moments in the story where you're just like, whoa, that's really changed how I think about all these things. And oh my goodness, you mean androids and life and what is the soul? And I was thinking, and I was kind of excited about it. I was like, wow, I've got to play more single player games. I feel like I'm missing out on all these experiences. As if I had missed out on various movies, classic films that other people had seen that I just hadn't experienced yet. But then I would play more of the game and it just started to become exactly how I felt about lots of other games that are single-player games. So I play Monster Hunter, I play Nier, I play Mario, I play Final Fantasy, I played Doom recently, I played God Eater, I played a whole ton of JRPGs as well. And suddenly during that Nier gameplay, I just had this moment. And it's actually on stream, you can actually go and find the VOD and there's a clip of me talking about it. But I was like, you know what, I just don't like playing single-player games. I just feel like The main thing that I'm doing is just going up against this machine. This machine acts like this, but if I dodge like this, then I can kill it. And then I move on to the next machine. And then there's a boss, and eventually, you know, it's got more HP than the other animals and... Animals? What? Monsters and creatures. But you beat that one eventually as well. To me, single-player games started to feel like homework. Like, here's just a task that you need to do. And I didn't understand. I was like, I thought I was done with homework. I've finally grown up, I've got a job, and I've actually got all this free time to do creative things. But then again, creative endeavors, they're its own minefield at some point. Even creative things can get kind of lacking in motivation. And as I was hacking and slashing through these enemies, it just got more and more clear to me that I was going up against machine after machine, and that was the reason why I wasn't getting any satisfaction out of it. Because even though it's called a single player game, I don't think single player games really are single player games. Almost every single player game has other characters that you have to knock over or beat. And so really, the enemies in a single player game make them all versus games. I feel like every game is a versus game. It's you versus the Goomba in Super Mario World 1. Or it's you versus these robots in Nier, or it's you versus the monsters in Monster Hunter World, or it's you versus the level, just like the platforms are in weird places, you've got to find a way to get through those platforms. The main thing about single player games is that even though they're all basically versus, it's always you versus something that's not human. And that's when I realized that's why I keep going back to fighting games. And I'm not trying to say that fighting games are better than single-player games, because single-player games still offer you these structured experiences that have been mapped out for you. You're gonna go to this town, you're going to go to that boss, you're going to fight that person, you're gonna have this discovery, and then you're going to feel really great when you complete it at the end. Like reading a book, watching a film. But with fighting games, it's the opposite, right? So even though it feels like the thing about fighting games is that you're versus a human opponent, it's more often the case that you never see your opponent in fighting games, especially in the online age, and especially in 2020 when we're not really allowed to go outside and go to events and see human opponents. And that's a special aspect of fighting games as well, but online, often you're just going up against, who knows, maybe there are machines. But unlike machines, they have habits, and they have personalities, and they have adaptability, the ability to start going completely random, or to maybe just continue those bad habits that eventually you can discover, expose them for, and then you find out how to beat that person. And ideally, you find out how to beat that person within the set, because actually, if that set ends, of, you know, it's usually best 2 out of 3 games. If that person disappears, you may never find them again on ranked mode online. Anyway, ground the beans, let's set up the coffee. And so it was during this gameplay of Nier, as I was hacking and slashing my way through these robots, and then when I was finished with the task, I would go back over to the town and speak to the person who would say, okay, now you need to go over to the desert, and you need to go and fight this person, then come back, and then you're going to upgrade your parts, then you're going to move on to the next bit. And I was like, why do I find this all just so much like a chore, just like homework? And when I really thought about it, I realized that of all the media that I consume, whether it's music, or video games, or film, or reading books, or reading manga, the only ones that really grab my attention and keep me going are the ones that help me discover a little bit more about myself. Now, I think I've spoken about this in a previous video before, but I was reading a book called Wired for Story, and one of the important things, takeaways from that book was that we love stories as people because it teaches us lessons that we would have otherwise had to learn by experiencing those things ourselves. So if the story is about how dinosaurs are dangerous and if you go up against a dinosaur, you're probably going to get eaten, aren't we glad that that's a story and not something that we actually had to go through ourselves and actually discover firsthand? That's why stories are so exciting, because in our brains, just over the millions and eons of years, we've just learned to believe that stories are going to teach us important lessons, and especially the ones that teach us what we believe about the world. Like, our worldview is formed around all these stories because we can't experience all these dangerous events ourselves, right? And so when I play a single player game, I feel like I've kind of exhausted the number of lessons that I can learn from them, which are, unless it's a video game that is heavily based on a very deep moving story, in which case I tend to just prefer to watch an actual film, then I just find that the tasks are just like things to just bide over the time until the next cutscene. I'm just like waiting. I feel like if I'm going to play a single player game, I may as well just play a film. Sorry, may as well just watch a film. But when I'm playing fighting games, it's like there's literally nothing else there except you, and because the opponent's not, you can't even really see the opponent. It's really just you and yourself. So while I was playing Nier, I was like, it's me versus the robots, or me versus the monsters in Monster Hunter, or me versus a final boss in Final Fantasy. But with a fighting game, it's like, it's just me versus my bad habits. And every time I played a fighting game, I found myself, instead of confronting enemies and new tactics and new combos I hadn't seen, it was never about whether this new enemy has something I've never seen before. It was always just me versus myself. Have I done my research to know what moves this character has? Have I done my practice to make sure that I can do these combos when I need to do them? Have I worked on my bad habits so that I stop pressing a button when I wake up and getting myself killed? Because in fighting games, if your opponent can predict that you're going to press a button and then you press a button anyway, and then they punish you with a different button, it's either a punish or a counter. Like, that's where the big damage comes from in fighting games. And so every time I won a battle or lost a battle or just watched a fighting game, I just constantly felt like I was being forced to look at myself and re-evaluate what it means to be as stubborn a person as I am. So unwilling to actually practice and unwilling to do the work that's required to improve. All right, time to taste some of this tasty Peru Mount Espalgo. Don't know if it's actually made on the mountain or if maybe the town is just named after the mountain that's nearby. Tastes like an underground tunnel. And so I guess as a takeaway from playing Nier on stream, and then continuing to try and play more single player games after that, and just constantly dropping them, I just cannot continue playing any of these games. And it comes to MMOs as well. I mean, I haven't got to the point where I'm playing with other people, and I think the interactions with other people might be interesting, but still, when I was going through Final Fantasy XIV, I just felt like, oh man, it's just task after task after task. What's it called? Fetch quest. Single players are just constantly trying to tell you a story, but in the way of getting in the way of that story are just constant fetch quests. And it's just like, you know, I think I might just spend 2 hours watching a movie where I can have the story expertly told to me. I don't need that ultra-realistic feel of I was the one who was there, and it's, I think, what it is with video games that allow you to do something that you can't really do with a book, is that you are the... I can't remember the word.
Agency.
Like, the main benefit of interactive type media is the ones that try to tell stories, especially single player content, are the ones that, because they're interactive, you feel like you have agency, or the character doesn't have its own agency when you switch the game off. When I switch off my Monster Hunter game, my character is not out there fighting monsters. My character is dormant. They're sitting there on pause waiting till I log back into the game. But Harry Potter, when I shut Harry Potter closed, like, Harry Potter still kind of exists out there somewhere. He's in the world, he's dealing with his family issues, he's dealing with his wizard issues, he's dealing with his friend issues and his teacher issues. By the way, I haven't even read Harry Potter. But beyond the feeling of living vicariously through a character, and so the story just feels a little more real, like I experienced it myself, I feel like an expertly crafted film or a well-written book can do easily as good a job of making me feel like I had kind of experienced it myself. And maybe it's not that single player games just aren't interesting to me, it's that maybe because games have kind of taken over the place of what, you know, kids maybe used to read books and watch films and watch TV in the old days, maybe it's because so many kids would rather play a game because it's a little bit more interactive and because they feel that agency and they feel like they are living those experiences. Maybe film has moved over to video games, and maybe that's why video games feel more like films. And I just feel like instead of video games becoming great storytelling places, they've just become places where the story is being told, but it takes absolutely forever, and I have to do all these fetch quests in between. It's like, can we just go back to when the stories were told by movies and by books? I don't mean that seriously. I actually still very much value single-player content and stories, but what I'm trying to say is that I find that the movies and the books and the music that I listen to, the ones that I keep going back to, are the ones where I feel different at the end. Like, physically, I've changed as a person at the end. And with a fighting game, I feel like that just happens more efficiently and more frequently, because I'm forced to confront myself, not just every match, not just every round, but literally every half a second or so. I'm like, I should have done that, I should have done that, I should have done that. And I feel like you just think that constantly throughout a match. Oh, I wish I'd done that, I wish I'd done that. I wish I'm gonna try this. Oh, that didn't quite work. You're constantly evaluating yourself. And to a point, it doesn't even really matter who your opponent is. You've just got a low-level opponent or you've got a high-level opponent, and either you actually manage to play the mind game and convince them that they should do this move right now, and then they actually do it and then you punish them, or you go on autopilot and you realize that you're just really, really stubborn, you refuse to learn, you refuse to practice, and you just don't like to actually get down and do the work. You would rather just autopilot. And what does that say about the rest of your life? The fact that your career's not going anywhere, that your relationships with people are not going anywhere? Is it because you're constantly trying to live on autopilot? And why did you feel that you need to go on autopilot? Was it because you had a challenge at some point and you had a bad experience and now you don't ever want to go out and find challenges and new challenges? You just want to go back to what feels easy. Basically, with fighting games, it just 100% exposes all the things that you don't want to confront about yourself. And that's why I really enjoy them, because single player games don't make me do that. Even to a large extent, films don't really make me do that. There are sometimes when I see a film that makes me think something I hadn't thought before, and I go, oh yeah, maybe I'm like that too. But with a fighting game, it makes you go, you're like this, you're autopiloting, you're not thinking about the situation, and now you've lost and it's all your fault, and you got no one else to blame. Now, the problem with this is that even though I think it makes fighting games intensely interesting, it also makes them horrifically punishing for new players coming in. Even though this is kind of what's so satisfying, if you can get over that hill where you're like, okay, here, you need to confront the fact that you're stubborn, you need to confront the fact that you want an easy life and you want to autopilot. If you can get past those, you don't have to solve those issues, but if you can get past those issues and then on the other side, you just slowly deal with those issues one by one by one until you actually start to improve at the game and improve as a person. And then your approach to everything else in your life starts to become a lot like your approach to fighting. And actually, before I ever played fighting games, I used to do martial arts, I did Taekwondo as a kid. And I remember I liked Taekwondo so much that I wrote my like personal statement, the one that you're supposed to use to convince a university to admit your application or admit your entrance to their university. You're supposed to write this essay that's supposed to prove how great you are. And I heard all about Taekwondo and how Taekwondo had completely changed my life and my outlook on the world and how everything is a challenge like this. And if only I could get better in this way, it would force me or encourage me to improve in this other way. My careers advisor read it and they were like, you need to make this less about Taekwondo. And I was like, it's not about Taekwondo, it's about the improvement. They didn't, you don't get it. But actually, my careers advisor did get it. They understood that whoever works in the admissions office was not going to see it the way that I saw it. And also, I had clearly not written the essay in a way that made it obvious that Taekwondo is not the point and that it was the other points, but I wasn't an expert writer back then. I was like 16 or 17, I can't remember. So getting back to single-player games, I started to realize that it's not even really the fault of single-player games that I don't want to play them. It's more the fault of fighting games and my encounter with them. I feel like once you've encountered a fighting game, it's very difficult to un-encounter them. It's difficult to go back to single-player games after that point because you're like, well, this doesn't do it for me anymore. It doesn't do it for me anymore. Because I'm looking for something completely different to what I was looking for before. And the same experience happens to me with classical music as well, and pop music, and dance music, and electronic music. Once I started looking for more, like I needed chord changes that were more interesting, I needed innovation in the way that they were expressing the words through the actual instrumental sounds and the orchestrations. For a long while, I just couldn't enjoy any pop music. I couldn't watch any film music. I was always just pulling it apart. I was like, ah, man, that should have been done like this. That should have been done like that. Or if only it had been done like this, it would have been more interesting. I think eventually I probably will get back to enjoying single player games, but it won't be until I can come back to understanding what I get from them, because I'm not getting from them what I used to get from them, which was sitting back and enjoying something that was kind of brand new to me. It was like a new world and a new experience. But after a while, those new experiences just became a chore. It's just like, okay, you're going to experience a fantasy world now. Okay, now you're going to experience a dungeon. Okay, now you're going to experience a really tough boss. Okay, now you're going to experience this dark corridor and you're gonna fall in a hole and you're not going to know that it's there. Really, when it comes down to it, I feel like it's dishonest when it says that it's a single-player game. It's not really. Most single-player games, apart from maybe Tetris, but that's its own special topic, I think. Most games that involve characters are actually not single-players. They're versus, and they're versus a machine. It's you and a machine, and it's you and this machine and some other corridor. But with a fighting game, it's you and a human opponent, and you have to deal with everything that it means to be human and what it means for that person to be human. And if you can't figure out their habits, if you can't control their habits, then you only have yourself to blame. And really, instead of it being versus another human, I feel like the most important thing that I found about fighting games is that it's me versus myself. And that sucks. But in a good way. And also in a way that it kind of makes it difficult for me to go back and experience single player games the way that I used to, as recreation, as relaxations. And I've turned it into this academic, I've turned gaming into this academic self-study thing. I think I might need to take up a new activity. It might be time to learn golf. Golf? What? I don't know why I said golf. I don't want to play golf. Anyway, just a super casual topic and something that I had been thinking about since I did that stream. It was a number of months ago now, since I had discovered, like, it's so difficult for me to get back into single-player games. And I do sometimes enjoy playing them, but I never get stuck into them, especially if they're like a 30-hour or 60-hour adventure. I just cannot see them to the end because I feel like once I've played 30 minutes of them or played an hour of them, I'm like, I've seen it all. I've seen everything that this game has to offer me. It's just more corridors, more NPCs, more fetch requests. And in the meantime, I know that these are all hours that I could be spending working on myself. and understanding more about myself, because there are very few experiences and very few forms of media that are capable of showing you a mirror and just going, this is what you are, this is who you are. And fighting games do that expertly. The takeaway from this video is play fighting games. Play rollback fighting games. That's all for now, but I'm curious to know how you feel about single player games. Is there a single player game that really surprised you and made you think, okay, I've really got to see this game to the end? Because I'm gonna be honest, even with Final Fantasy VII Remake, I was like, oh my god, I can finally play Final Fantasy VII in high resolution! It's just, oh man, it's just quest after quest after quest, and please fetch this, please fetch that, and please go down this corridor that used to be 5 minutes long and now it's 50 minutes long. It's like every experience that used to be a 5 minute thing in FF7 is now this like long 1 hour corridor that I've got to run down and got to shut down 8 reactors or something in order to open up a door to the next place, which I already, I don't know. Just tell me, if you've got a single player game that you recommend, please let me know in the comments below. And if you're not already subscribed and you want to hear or see more videos about coffee, Japan, fighting games, art, all that great stuff, do consider subscribing to the channel, clicking that little notification bell. And if you want to join us, there's a link to the Discord where we can chat off, where we can chat about videos and games and stuff. And until then, I'm going to be busy cleaning up my desk because I'm just incapable of making a video without making a huge mess. I'll see you all in the next NihongoGamer video.